Our story begins in Anrea, a land of adventure and magic in the Forgotten Realms. This is also the land Riva Hornraven was born in. Riva grew up in the village of Levik as the daughter of the famous barbarian warrior and leader of the tribe, Golan Hornraven. Golan never talks about Riva's mother. Some nights though, he drinks too much and talks to the ocean alone. Riva knows though that her mother was a pirate captain who joined Golan and helped pillage a monastery. Years later, Golan returned to Levik, alone, but carrying Riva, and if rumors is to be believed, also a great treasure of gold and silver. At Riva's 16th birthday, as was her right, she chose to live by the sword. She traveled to the nearby fortress Ravenloft to join the city guard. At the application test, Riva got into trouble. She was useless with the sword. The swordmaster started to taunt her and make fool of her, and he hit her repeatedly with the blunt side of the sword. And suddenly, the world turned red and black for Riva. When her vision returned, the swordmaster lay in a bloody heap by her feet, and parts of him strewn over all the place. She could even taste him on the way back to her father. At his father's hall, she told everything that happened to Golan. He didn't seem surprised. He has told one of the soldiers to go get the skeg axe from the armory. He placed the long-shafted, beautiful axe in her hands. The axe longer than Riva herself and extremely heavy. Then he told her that this was now her axe. A family skeg axe. Too big and heavy for a normal person. Then he told her a story. A story about the family curse and a family blessing, gifted in battle by a divine creature, asked for in desperation in a time of need. Odd blood was the name for it. Some called it Berserker Rage, but that name is too light for the odd blood, as a berserker can control who he or she kills when the battle madness comes. After the story, Golan sent Riva with a band of mercenaries and Vikings out in the world. She experienced many adventures with them before they went separate ways, and Riva continued her adventure alone. And here we now find Riva as a caravan guard on the road to Dawn. In the caravan, Riva noted beside the caravan owner, Jonathan, four other individuals travel. Harold, the snobby priest Riva tried to avoid. A soft, pretty female druid called Sinanera. And a monk with a ridiculous name I see too much. Also, a mysterious man who tried to hide the, in Riva's opinion, very pretty burn mark in his face.